In this class, we will discuss how to solve the stepped bar problems. Consider the problem as shown in figure. It has a two steps, that is a two sections. And the problem here is to determine nodal displacements, element stress and support reactions. First, you create a finite element model manually for this and try to have a complete picture of this, like how many elements you want, how many nodes you want. Since this member has a three nodes here, mark a 3 points and join with the lines and you call them as an element. So here we are denoting lines, nodes, displacement at each node and forces acting at each node. So here Q1 and F1 are the displacement and force acting at node 1. Q2 and F2 are the displacement and force acting at node 2 and Q3 and F3 is the displacement and force acting at node 3. By comparing the given problem with the drawn sketch of the FEM, so here Q1 is 0, Q3 is 0 as these two are fixed ends. Node 1 fixed and node 3 is fixed here. And the force applied is 200 kN. So in order to solve this problem in ANSYS, you need to have some basic preparation for that. So considering this problem, tabulate the nodal coordinate values. Node 1, 0, 0 means choosing this node 1 as origin and you have to tabulate all this value. So node 2 is 300, 0 and node 3 is 700, 0. And section 1 has a Young's modulus of 70. 10^3 newton per millimeter square. Second section has a 200 × 10^3 newton per millimeter square. First section area is 2400 millimeter square. Second section has a 600 millimeter square. So let them call it as a section set 1, section set 2, material set 1, material set 2. So then you need to make a one element connector table and that explains how we are connecting elements and which properties we are assigning for each element. Element 1, we are connecting from node 1 to node 2 and with a Young's modulus of material set 1 and section set 1. Element 2 with a 2 and 3, material set 2 and a section set 2. And what we are going to determine and we are going to find results. Displacement at each node, reaction at each node and axial stresses in each member. Let us see how to solve this problem in ANSYS. Go to preferences, structural, say OK, preprocessor, element type, add. So here you select link 180 element, close it, go to material properties, material models, structural, linear, elastic, isotropic. First set you need to create 70 exponential 3 and 0.3. Then second set, for that click on the new model, here assign the set value, then enter here 200 exponential 3 and a Poisson's ratio is 0.3. Say OK. Ensure that you have created a two material sets. Once you completed this, go to ANSYS. Sections, here link, click on the add. First set you need to create with a cross section value of 2400. Say OK. 2400. Then second set you need to create for a So I will call it as A2 and this is 600. So we have created a two sets, then you need to build a FE model. So for that go to modeling, create nodes in ActiveCS. First node you create at 0, 0. Second node you create at 300, 0. Third node you create at 700, 0 as per the table. So now we have a three nodes. Then go to elements. Here select the first element with what properties you need to create, material 1 and A1. Say OK. Then user numbered through nodes, say element 1 from node 1 to node 2. Then change the attributes here, material to 2 and section to 2. Say OK. And through nodes, second element now from 2 to 3. So we have built a FE model. Then assign the boundary conditions, that is displacements and forces. Displacement on nodes, first node and a third node are having 0. For that you need to arrest by assigning a 0 value. Then go to force on nodes. Here you apply a load off in x direction. Load is, it is 200 kilonewton. 200 kilonewton in the positive direction. Say OK. We applied a load here. So with that, creation of FE model is completed. Then go to solution, solve the problem. Solution is obtained and close the information window. Go to general post processor, least results, nodal solution, DOF solution, displacement vector sum. Say OK. Now here it is. Go to the results page. Here it is. Then the displacement at node 3 is 0.2356, at node 1 is 0 and node 2 is 0. So this table will explain at node 1 what is the displacement in x direction, what is the displacement in the y direction, what is the displacement in the z direction, like that. Node 2, node 3. Close this. Go to the reaction solution, select all items, say OK. And here at node 1, a force of a reaction force minus 0.130223 into 10 to the power of minus 6 is induced at node 1. Similarly at node 2, a force of, say, node 3. And node 2, there won't be any reaction force as we didn't constrain there. Then go to the answers for listing the element axial stress. Go to element table, define, add. Here you type stress, scroll down, select the option by sequence number. The right hand side you select LS, enter 1 from the keyboard, save OK and close it. And in the here in the menu you select list element table, stress, save OK. And here stress is 54.264 is the axial stress in the first member, and in the second member it is minus 11.68. So the with this it is a minus. First stress is under tensile and second is member is under compression. So with this I conclude the problem solution. Then I will display some more problems for a practice. So this has a 3 steps and this has a 2 steps, but on a section 1 at the middle there is a load of 20 kilonewton. So this problem, first problem you can solve with 3 elements, and a second element, all second problem also you should solve for the by considering 3 elements. I hope you understood the solution, how to solve using ANSYS. Thank you.